Ridgeside K9. Guys, we are here with a fearful black lab. We've been working with this dog for almost 2 weeks straight. And it's a very, very difficult board train. This is a dog that even to this day will not take treats, will not take affection, and will not take food in any capacity from me, okay? Or my wife or anybody else. Now, part of our rehabilitation slash training, because that's what this is not about sit down, stand, spin left, spin right. This is about very serious behavior modification. Has been taking this dog, good boy, super, taking this dog on long walks, okay? The walk is problematic because, again, he does not know how to walk. Anytime he gets fearful, he shuts down. Anytime something happens, he shuts down. He avoids.
His opposition reflex is very high. So get out here, we're walking with him just to get him to stay with us, okay? Again, I can't give him my treat because he won't take it. No toy. No anything. So we're using tone and vibration to condition the dog right now. So all I'm going to do is come on time. He can hear it.
Yes!
Okay. Proximity to me deactivates tone. So we're working on a recall with tone on. You better pressure the leash.
Yes!
The only thing I want to do is come to me and it deactivates the tone right now.
Yes, good boy, super.
This is unlocked, okay? And all points in time it is flexy. I love a flexy. People are going to talk about it. Trust me, they're good tools if they use correctly. This is unlocked. All they're going to do is stay in my proximity. Operation, no stem yet. See the shutdown, right? I don't want that. A little bit of police pressure.
Good.
Him moving turns off all this pressure. Him shutting down immediately activates police pressure.
No. step. Just step one.
Turns off all connection to
walk away pretty soon, he will want to stay with us. It takes time, it takes repetition, it takes long-term consistency. Very, very, very important. That's it, guys. Wish I could, let us know how we can help you.
Alright guys, and in closing here to Slab, myself, my wife, anybody that comes here is willing to put in rest of this dog. We try to mix it up every day as much as possible. to really get in there that you can just hang and relax and, you know, get affection. In measured doses. So, too much affection with this dog will shut him down. Try to do happy-go-lucky petting, scratching, high pitch, and do all the stuff like you would do with a normal dog will way overstimulate and shut him down. Calm strokes, just like a mother does to a puppy, okay? Very important to keep the dog not getting overwhelmed. But that's it, guys. Dogs that just take consistency, they do take absolute mandatory, if you believe anything I say right now. A dog like this will never move forward, let alone you've got to train a dog. You've got to give corrections and a little bit of pressure to force a dog to move forward. As soon as you can force a dog out of his bubble, move him forward. Force him to simply walk with you. You'd be surprised at what can happen long term. But that's it, guys. Ridgeside Canine. Again, for anybody else, this dog was not abused in any capacity by his owner. This dog is bad genetics. But the owner made a commitment, and way too much affection, love, and reinforcing bad behavior. So, the only time he gets affection here is when he's outside of the kennel, using his nose like he is right now, and just, you know, complying to presence, i.e. staying with us. Don't pull away, don't run away, don't shut down, just be with us. So he saw me getting affection, he was holding that sit right next to me. He likes my wife, he's much more at ease with her than he is with me. But she gives him affection when he's on place and just relaxing. So it's a whole process. 2 weeks is a very short amount of time to break through a dog like this, but we're going to lay this
foundation. It's being laid, and the owner will continue for a lifelong journey. That's it, guys. Ridgeside Canine.